It's about kind of making the law, treating the global community as small. So I worked with, I was very lucky to work in Cyber Salon with a guy called Andy Cameron, who unfortunately passed away a couple of years ago. And he was always telling us, he headed Hypermedia Research Center in Westminster, which is one of the first networked master degrees. And he was always telling me that the digital community will only work if we treat it as a physical community. That the guy next to you in cyberspace, it's the same like the guy next to you at your table. And only when we bring the roles and understanding of that community in that manner, we will actually be successful in creating truly global village. And at that time, it was quite a few years ago, I thought, you know, if somebody is in Hong Kong, okay, I can see him in my inbox, but he's still in Hong Kong. But I think I came around to understand what he was trying to say, that digital space does shrink distance, and the behavior online needs to be executed in the same way like we would treat our physical neighbor. Because when you see how all the trolling and the gamer gates and all the sexism and misogyny and, you know, even within the gamer community itself, there's a lot of wars going on. People kind of forget that, you know, if we were in the same room, we will just have one big debate and settle it. And we have to get back to that, that, you know, we have to bring ourselves to understand that we are in the same room. It might be a bit bigger, but it's still the same room. Because if we treat the digital, our digital neighbors as people from different community who work on different rules and different netiquette, it will never work. So now the globalization got to the point that, you know, the kids in Hong Kong really are our digital neighbors and physical neighbors. So we've got to grapple with it. So we developed this concept of digital citizenship, which is sort of, you know, I'm a mom of three kids, so I'm quite tough. And I think we are not tough enough with our digital neighbors and with ourselves in digital space. So sometimes we let things go, like 4chan and the trolling, you know, we just let it go. Oh, it's just boys playing. But actually it's quite harmful. And assuming that you can behave differently in cyberspace is probably outlived its usefulness. So we need to maneuver forward and negotiate the digital citizenship in a way that, yes, rights, yes, privileges, but yes, responsibility. And that's going to be hard because people got used to the sort of wild area of cyberspace. But I think we're coming to the point where we're going to say enough and work out the new rules.